Hey guys, welcome to my channel Total Angrezi by Vidushi. Do subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon to never miss an update, and do give me a thumbs up if you like the video. So today we have taken up another poem from grade 10 syllabus. It's Amanda by Robin Klein. So this is one of the best and easiest explanations that you're going to find on YouTube, and it's like a complete guide for your English learning. And we'll be going through the entire explanation, we'll be going through a summary, a very good touch of vocabulary, and some important questions. So let's begin. Don't bite your nails, Amanda. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Stop that slouching and sit up straight, Amanda. So this is how the poem begins, wherein we can see that there is a mother who's scolding this little girl whose name is Amanda. She says, don't bite your nails, don't hunch your shoulders. What is hunch? It means to curl down in your posture. You can see there's a picture of a hunched back girl sitting on the right hand side of the screen. So that's what she's saying. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Stop that slouching and sit up straight. Slouching also means the same, that don't shrug your shoulders. Sit straight, Amanda. So you can see that the mother is constantly nagging the little girl. Now this is when the girl is becoming upset and she goes into an imaginary world. And what does she imagine? There is a languid emerald sea where the sole inhabitant is me, a mermaid drifting blissfully. Languid is a calm thing, you know. So she's saying that she wishes that there was a languid, there was a calm. Emerald is the color green, so the rich green color. She's saying that she's imagining a calm ocean, a calm sea, green in color, and the only inhabitant is me. Inhabitant is the person who lives, the person who lives there in a habitat. So she's saying that the only person who lives there is she herself. She is Amanda, a mermaid drifting blissfully. You know what a mermaid is. You can see a mermaid on the left hand side of the screen. So she's saying that in this sea, she should be all alone. There should be nobody to talk to, not even her mother. And blissfully, happily, she will roam about in this emerald sea. Then the stanza again comes back to the mother's nagging. Did you finish your homework, Amanda? Did you tidy your room, Amanda? I thought I told you to clean your shoes, Amanda. So here again, the mother is going on nagging. She's going on giving the little girl instructions. She's not letting the girl do what she wants to do. She asks her if she finished her homework. Did she clean her room? And she also reminds her that I told you to clean your shoes. Why haven't you cleaned your shoes yet? So these are the kind of instructions and nagging that a mother is giving to Amanda. And then again, she comes back into an imagination. I am an orphan roaming the street. An orphan is a child who has no parents, whose parents are dead. So now she's imagining that she wishes that she was an orphan. That is, she didn't have anybody and she would roam about the streets. I pattern soft dust with my hushed bare feet. So she can quietly walk with nobody talking around her, with nobody telling her what to do. She can be on her own and she can make hushed patterns on the soft dust, and she can walk quietly there. The silence is golden, the freedom is sweet. The silence is golden, they're using a phrase over here. She's saying that there will be nobody to talk around me, and that silence will seem golden, it will seem blissful, it will seem happy. And this freedom is sweet, which means that she's free from all the nagging, she's free from all the instructions, she is alone and she is happy. Don't eat that chocolate, Amanda. Remember your acne, Amanda. Will you please look at me when I'm speaking to you, Amanda? So there again, the mother is screaming at her. She's nagging her. She's saying, don't eat chocolates. You will get acne. Acne is these face marks that you get. Sometimes it is hereditary. Sometimes you get it due to sugar. Sometimes you get it due to overeating oil. There are different reasons. So her mother is reminding her that if you eat too many chocolates, you will get acne on your face. Now the child is not worrying about her physical looks. She doesn't care about it. She's a little girl. But the mother thinks that people will look at her and you know what, she won't look beautiful. She'll grow up with acne. The mother doesn't want that. So she's reminding her. And then the girl is upset. She's not looking at the mother's face. She's looking here and there because she's fed up of her mother constantly nagging her. So the mother has to again scream at her and she says, "Will you please look at me when I'm speaking to you, Amanda?" This happens a lot when we look around here and there. Our teachers and our parents will say that, "Don't look here and there. Look at me when I'm talking to you." So that's exactly what is happening to Amanda. And then again, she's into this imaginary world where she says, "I am Rapunzel. I have not a care. Life in the tower is tranquil and rare. I'll certainly never let down my bright hair." So Rapunzel is a fairy tale where this character, female character Rapunzel, was locked up in a high tower by a mean lady, and she has long golden hair, and in the end she lays down her golden hair through the window through which the prince is able to save her. So she's comparing herself to Rapunzel now, and she's saying that she wished that she was Rapunzel and somebody had locked her in that tower so that she would have nothing to care about outside. Life in a tower is tranquil and rare. Tranquil is again peaceful. So she says that even though Rapunzel was locked up, she wishes to be locked up there so that nobody would talk to her, nobody would scream at her, nobody would nag her, and that life would be rare. It would be different for her. "I'll certainly never let down my bright hair." Now she is trying to contradict the story of Rapunzel, where Rapunzel laid down her golden hair so that she could be saved. But this girl says, "I'll certainly never let down my bright hair," because she doesn't want to meet anybody. She's so fed up that she doesn't even want to see a chance in the future of being saved from all of this, and she feels that she wants to live alone. That is why she says she'll never let down her bright hair so that she never has to speak to anyone again. "Stop that sulking at once, Amanda. You're always so moody, Amanda. Anyone would think that I nagged at you, Amanda." So this is the last stanza, coming to the end. She says, "Stop that sulking." She means stop being so upset. Stop looking so sad, Amanda. "You act so moody. Anyone would think that I nagged at you." This is what happens when parents or somebody would scream. Sometimes they would say, "Okay, don't do that. Don't make your face like that. People, what will people think that I scolded you?" So now the mother is, first she screamed at her the entire day, she nagged her, and now when Amanda is fed up, she's feeling sad, she's feeling sulky, the mother is saying that, "Don't do that because people will think that I have nagged at you." So this is how the poem ends. By the end, we see that she's out of imaginations because she's so upset that she cannot imagine to be free anymore. She's completely sad. Let's go into the summary, but before that, let me tell you, subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon so that you can get a notification, and give us a thumbs up if you like the video. So let's come back to a quick summary of the poem. This poem is about a little girl, Amanda, who's constantly nagged by her mother. Amanda remains very unhappy about that. The poet has used a beautiful technique in this poem to express what the girl dreams of when her mother nags at her. Amanda craves for freedom. First, she dreams of being free in a calm ocean like a mermaid. She then gets so fed up of the constant nags that she dreams of being an orphan who doesn't have anyone to tell her what to do. And finally, she relates herself with a famous fairy tale character, Rapunzel, and yearns to be alone in a tower just like her. She wishes to never let down her hair for anyone so that she can live how she likes. By the end of it, when the imaginations end, the poem makes us feel sorry for Amanda. Let's run by some extra questions and I'll discuss the answers with you. Why does Amanda's mother scold her for having a chocolate? Because the mother is worried that when she has a chocolate, because of the sugar intake, Amanda will have acne, and the mother is really concerned about her physical appearance, and she doesn't realize that she is killing her child's wants and likings all the time. Do you think Amanda is in a bad mood throughout this poem? Why? Amanda gets in a worse mood after every stanza of the poem. Why? Because her mother is constantly nagging her. She's not letting her do anything she likes, and Amanda is getting upset because she doesn't have any freedom. Why does Amanda dream of being an orphan? An orphan is a person who doesn't have any parents. So Amanda is so fed up of her mother's constantly scolding her, constantly not letting her do the things she wants to do, that she dreams of being an orphan. imagining that at least that girl, an orphan girl, will not have any parents to scream at her. She can do whatever she wants. She can roam around the street, she can make patterns on the sand, and that is why she dreams of being an orphan. What do you think is Amanda's intention behind staying in her tower? Amanda wants to stay in her tower so that she can be locked up there. She would have nobody to talk to, she would have nobody to meet, and she can stay inside and do whatever she wants. She can eat her chocolates, she can sit the way she wants, she can stand the way she wants, she can color, she can study, she cannot do her homework if she doesn't want to. And that is the intention behind Amanda's intention of staying in the tower. Mention Amanda's three imaginations. So her three imaginations are: one, to be a mermaid in the calm emerald sea. The second one is to be an orphan where she can just roam about the streets and make patterns on the sand. And the third is to be locked up in a tower like Rapunzel and never be let out of there. Do you think Amanda's mother is right for scolding her? This is a completely your perspective answer. I'm going to give you my perspective. No, Amanda's mother is not right in scolding her for everything. Amanda is a little girl and she has the right to do a little mischief. She has the right to eat some chocolates if she wants to. Plus, even if the mother is trying to make is trying to grow Amanda in a better way, the constant nags will only make Amanda a sad and depressed person, and she will not remember her childhood and her mother fondly when she grows up. So all of these things have to happen gradually. You cannot scold one girl one entire day and make her change in a day. That's not going to happen. What do you think about the title of this poem, Amanda? The mother constantly keeps screaming at Amanda, and you can see that in all of those lines she keeps saying, Amanda, don't do this, Amanda, don't do that. And then Amanda goes into her own imagination. That is why the poet, to add emphasis to the entire poem, to add emphasis on the central theme of the poem, he has kept the title simple as Amanda. In your own words, describe the theme of this poem. So what do you think is the theme of this poem? We've gone through it. This poem is about the happiness of a little girl who's yearning for freedom. She wants to be free. She doesn't want to be constantly nagged or scolded by her mother. The theme of this poem is to let children grow they want to grow. They should be taught about the right and wrongs and what they should do and what they shouldn't do. But they shouldn't be nagged and scolded for the entire day. Such kind of things have to be done gradually. And through this poem, the poet wants to send out this strong message to parents that this isn't how you should bring up your child. So he's trying to give a strong message on the correct upbringing. There are also some long questions you can look at, which you can answer now using the explanation, the summary, and the short answers. What is Amanda's escape mechanism for happiness? We all know it is her imaginations. Support your answer with examples from the poem. So here you will explain all the imaginations. And what do you learn about Amanda from it? What do we learn? That Amanda is so upset. Amanda is so sad that she doesn't get to do anything in the house that she wants to do, including something as small as eating a chocolate. Then we learn that Amanda is very upset. So this is where you have to explain from the poem how the mother is constantly screaming at her, how the mother is constantly yelling at her, and how Amanda wants to escape from it. And she imagines being a mermaid, she imagines being locked in a tower, she imagines being an orphan. She imagines all the sad parts of life, because that would make her happier rather than the happy parts of life, where she can afford a chocolate but she can't have it. She can have parents but she cannot enjoy their parenthood. So this is exactly how you're supposed to frame your answer in your own words. Is the poet Robert Klein able to establish his idea behind proper upbringing of a child through this poem? How? Again, this is your point of view. According to me, yes, he is not directly telling the parents what they are doing wrong. But through this poem, he's trying to convey to the parents what they shouldn't do and what kind of things make a child upset. So you have to explain this with examples from and lines from the poem. Summarize the poem, Amanda. Is there anything you learned from it? Give reasons for your answer. So you tell the examiner, is there anything you're learning from it? Maybe you are learning that in future, if we have little siblings or children or whatever, this is not how they should be brought up. At the same time, you learn that we have to try and make do with things that we have. But we have to also, if you're sad, if you're feeling upset, it is okay to go and tell somebody that, you know, this is upsetting me. Please don't do this. Summary of the poem, I'm sure you've got it covered from the explanation and the summary, and you have to support your answer with reasons. So I hope this video has helped you. We'll be back with another poem. Until then, bye-bye.